So in this video, we are going to look at the second method and the third method on how to generate electromotive force or EMF potential. Okay, so what is the second method? The second method is when we have a moving conductor but the magnetic field is static. So we consider the condition here. So let's say we have a wire and the wire has a length of L and it's moving across a magnetic field B. Okay, so in this case it's moving in the positive X direction, while the magnetic field is going out of the page in the direction of positive Z. Okay, so it's going out of the page. And let's say the wire contains electrons, free electrons. So, when we consider the magnetic force acting on a particle with charge Q moving, so the charge is inside the wire and the wire is moving, cutting across the magnetic field. So we can go back to the magnetic force equation obtained from magnetostatics, Fm equals to Q U cross B. So the magnetic force is equivalent to the electrical force that will be exerted on the particle by the electric field Em. So if you recall from electrostatic, we have E equals to F divided by Q. So if we have charge Q inside here, then the electric field strength, okay, the force from electric field or the electric field strength can be found by this equation E equals to F divided by Q, which is equal to U cross B. So this in turn induces a voltage difference between the two endpoints. So between 1 and 2 is going to be a voltage difference. And the voltage difference can be calculated using this equation. So we have V12 equals to integration of Em dot dl, where Em is equal to U cross B dot dl. Alright. For the conducting wire, in this case, U cross B, so the velocity of the wire is moving in the X direction, so we have direction X and the magnitude is U, and B is the direction is positive Z and the magnitude, let's say, is B naught. So when we cross product these two, X cross Z, we are going to get direction negative Y, and U B naught, you get the magnitude. So this is the motional EMF between point 1 and 2, which is given as negative U B naught L. Right, so if from the motional EMF we want to generate current and we want to for the current to flow in the circuit, then it needs to be a closed loop. So that's why we have a closed integral here, because if it's open circuit, then it's going to be only the EMF potential. So we want to convert it into current, then we need to have a closed circuit. So in general, if any segment of a closed circuit with contour C moves with velocity U across a static magnetic field, then we are going to have this induced motional EMF. And it's important to note that only those segments that cross the magnetic field contribute to the motional EMF. Okay, so let's see example of what this means. Consider this figure. This figure is a sliding bar. Right, so we have two like rails here, fixed rails made from a conductive material, and the terminals is connected with a resistor R, and we have another conductor here that is placed on top of the rail, and only this part here, section 3 to 4, is moving, and it's moving in the direction of positive X, indicated by this arrow here, at the speed of U. and it's cutting across the magnetic field that is pointing out of the page in the positive Z direction. So you see there's a gradient shape of the magnetic field. This indicates that the magnetic field increases linearly as X value increase. So as you go further down the X axis, the magnetic field becomes stronger, right? So the magnetic field equation is given by direction. Direction is positive Z. Magnitude is V naught, and is going to change with X because X increases. As X increases, the B also increase. So we have this equation for the magnetic field, and note that B increases with X. Okay, so what is the question? So we want to find the motional EMF between terminals 1 and 2 and the current I flowing through the resistor R. And then we need to prove that the same result can be found using the general formula of Faraday's law. So let's calculate the motional EMF first. Now, as I mentioned previously, only the part that crosses the magnetic field is involved in generating the motional EMF. So in this case, these rails here are fixed. It doesn't move. So it does not generate motional EMF. This part here also is fixed, 1 and 2. So it does not generate motional EMF. The motional EMF is only generated by this segment here, 3 and 4, as it moves across the magnetic field. But since segment 3 and 4 is parallel with 1 and 2, so the voltage induced in this segment is going to be the same as the voltage induced in this segment. But for calculation, we only need to calculate between segment 3 to 4. So, V motional EMF, so we need to calculate between segment 3 and 4. We utilize the equation U cross V dot DL. So, DL is the differential length. Differential length is given by the length of the segment, which is L. Right, so the speed or the velocity U is given by direction X, magnitude U. And for the magnetic field, we have direction Z, B naught, X naught. So because the X value always change as this bar moves. So let's say now the distance is at X naught, right? And the direction of the segment itself, or the bar itself, is in the positive Y direction, DL. So that's why we have Y here. So we apply dot product. First, we apply cross product, X cross Z. We are going to get the direction is negative Y. And then negative Y dot Y, we are going to get negative 1. The Y will cancel out, so we get negative value. So we have U, B naught, X naught, and then when we integrate over DL, we are going to get L because it's the length of the line, so you get this part here. So the length of the loop is related to the speed by X naught equals to UT. So X naught here, the distance is, let's say, in meters, right? The unit, the standard unit is in meters. U is the speed. Speed is meter per second, and then T is the time taken for it to reach. So time is given as second. So when we have meter, here we have meter per second and second, the second cancel out. So we can replace X naught equals to UT. So now we replace UT in the equation, we get the motional EMF equals to negative B naught U squared, because you have UT here, U squared LT. So this is how you calculate the motional EMF. Then we can replace the values of magnetic field, the speed, the length, and so on for any value and get the actual motional EMF. Now, we settle this part here. Now we want to prove the result can be obtained using form general formula of Faraday's law. Okay, so using Faraday's law, first we calculate the flux. So flux is the surface integral of magnetic field. So magnetic field is here, direction of Z B not X. And the surface area is going to be differential X multiplied by differential Y. This is going to be the area. Right? So dot product Z dot Z going to get 1. So we have B not X dx dy. Now dy is fixed because dy always equivalent to the length of the segment L. So we have B naught L. While x is going to depend on the distance from the starting point to where the sliding bar is located with respect to the x-axis. So we are going to integrate over x, dx, from the range of 0 to x naught, whatever the x naught value may be. So we get, when we integrate, we're going to get x squared over 2. We replace with x naught. So we get b naught l x naught squared over 2. This is the equation for the flux. Now we differentiate. First, we replace first the same relationship. X naught equals to ut in the equation. So you're going to have b naught l u squared t squared over 2. Now we differentiate the flux over time using the Faraday's law, when and we apply negative because we follow Lenz's law. So since we only need to differentiate over t, so d over dt t squared, we are going to get 2t, and the 2 cancel out, we get negative b naught u squared lt. So this is the same result as the one that we showed earlier when we calculate using the motional EMF equation. So we prove that either we use motional EMF or Faraday's law general equation, we still get the same result. Now to calculate the current, we simply divide the voltage VMF here by the resistance value. Okay, so divide this value here by R to get the current. And since the direction is negative, then the direction of the current should follow the direction of the figure here, is going to be clockwise. Okay, let's look at another example. So we have a wire. We assume that the wire is infinitely long. It's not mentioned in the question, but we can assume to simplify our analysis. And then let's say we have a moving rod, a metal rod that is moving in the direction positive Z. So the wire itself carries a current of 10 amps. So if you use the right hand rule, you're going to find that there will be magnetic flux or magnetic field around the wire carrying the current. And because it's going upwards, so the magnetic field will go out of the page from the left hand side and into the page from the right hand side. Okay, so if you take your right hand now and you point your thumb to the direction of the current, so you'll see that the four fingers will follow a direction where on the left hand side the magnetic field comes out of the page, and on the right hand side the magnetic field goes into the page. So we have a metal rod. The metal rod is 30 centimeters, and the starting point of the metal rod is located 10 centimeters from the wire carrying current. So as we go further from the wire, the magnetic field will become much weaker. So the magnetic field is stronger here, and then as we go along the metal rod, the magnetic field will decrease slowly. So there will be a magnetic field difference, the strength. So we want to find what is the motional EMF generated between these two ends as it moves along the Z-axis. Okay, So because we assume it's an infinitely long wire, we can utilize this equation we obtained from magnetostatics, B equals to mu naught I divided by 2 pi R. Okay, so the magnetic field will only depend on the permeability, the magnitude of the current and the distance, the radius. Okay, so applying motional EMF equation, U, we have magnitude of 5 meter per second in the direction of Z. And then B, we replace this equation here. The direction is V. And then for the length, DL, the DL is going to depend on the cylindrical radius, R. Okay, dr, because this is the cylindrical radius r. So we want to integrate. This one is 10 centimeter from the wire, so 10 centimeter. This one is 40 centimeter, 10 plus 30, so it's 40 centimeter. So we want to integrate between these two range. So applying mathematical principles, we get this value here, and then we need to integrate over 1 for the range of 1 over r. So we can find actually 1 over r is equal to ln. So we replace the value 10 centimeter and 40 centimeter because the unit is the same, so we can cancel out. So we get ln 10 over 40. And by multiplying the values given, we get the answer as 13.9 microvolts. Okay, this is the motional EMF generated between the two ends as it moves along the z-axis. Okay. So, another application or one application that utilizes motional EMF is the electromagnetic generator. So, an electromagnetic generator, basically, we have a coil and we have a fixed magnetic field. Okay, let's say the magnetic field is put north and south on the top and bottom of the coil here. Now, as the coil moves, you see that these two segments, which is segment 1 and 2, and segment 3 and 4, is going to cut the magnetic field as it turns around. So, as it cuts the magnetic field, it's going to generate motional EMF. Right? So, because it's fixed at a center point, so we are going to apply the principle of torque. Because it's fixed, so the force is rotational. So, when we talk about velocity now, because it's fixed at its center point, we're talking about angular velocity. So, segment 1 and 2, let's say it moves at velocity u, is going to be given by this equation here. So, omega is angular velocity. So we have the direction of n, because the direction is rotational, so we are going to use n. So we have omega multiplied by omega divided by 2. And we also have n cross z, which is z is the direction of the magnetic field and n is the direction of the speed of the rotation. So we are going to have x multiplied, direction of x multiplied with sine alpha. So this is the some trigonometric principle. So if segment 1 and 2 moves with velocity u, segment 3 and 4 moves the same velocity but opposite direction. So we have negative u. Negative is simply opposite direction. So we can utilize the motional EMF equation to get this this integration. Right? So, once we settle the integration part, we are going to obtain this value here. So, omega is the angular velocity, right? And then, sorry, omega is here. Here is W. W is the width. W is the width of the coil. L is the length of the coil. So, length times width, we can get area. So, it's replaced by the letter A, the W and L here is replaced by A, which is area. And then we have omega B naught sine alpha. Okay. And alpha is given by the relationship of omega T plus C naught. So we can replace alpha as this equation here. Now, so we finished the second method. Now, finally, we move to the third method where we combine transformer EMF and motional EMF. So, for a singleton, let's say N equals to 1, this is the induced EMF, so we can combine them, and it's actually equal to the closed line integral of the electric field strength. Okay, this is obtained from principle of electrostatics previously. And the transformer EMF is equivalent to this one, and the motional EMF is equivalent to this one. So now, when we have a moving loop and a moving conductor, we can generate both EMF and we can add them together. Furthermore, the general expression from Faraday's law is given by this one. So basically, from these two, we can conclude that either we use this part or we use this part, we are going to get the same result. So both these equations are valid. The choice whether to use this part or this part will depend on the configuration that we want to solve. Okay, some configuration easier for us to apply this one, some easier to apply this one. In most cases, I believe this one is the best option. But sometimes this one can make the problem solve easier, be solved easier. Okay, so for n more than 1, we need to multiply the right hand side here with n. The number of turns will increase the emotional EMF, the potential EMF. Okay, so that's the end of this video session.